Hey YouTube, how's it going? It's me, R-Squad911, back again with another unboxing video, and today I got something cool, pretty fun, relatively inexpensive. It is the Ghostbusters Ecto Goggles from Spirit Halloween. I think it was only like $29 US plus shipping. Usually when it gets closer to Halloween, these things are sold out and you cannot get your hands on it, but since I got the Proton Pack, I need something inexpensive. Because I'm going to wear it, I'm going to go out for Halloween. I'm not specifically going as Ray, because Ray usually wears these goggles, but I just wanted to have like a cool getup. I'm going to have the Ghostbusters coveralls, the elbow pads, the belt, the proton pack, obviously, and goggles, and maybe a ghost trap hanging off the belt, which would be pretty cool. So, let's open this thing up. It's a pretty fun little... costume accessory. I was going to get the Mattel version, but that was like 300 US. And if I got the Hollywood Collectibles one, I think that was like 499 US. And that was retail, so I'm not even sure what it's at now. I wish I bought it back then, but yeah, I wasn't really interested in having a static prop. And I don't know, I don't think I'd want to wear a $300 to $500 pair of collectibles on my head for Halloween, right? But yeah, this is actually pretty impressive. Got the battery door here. Not very movie accurate, but I'm pretty sure I can sand off that and some stuff and paint those black so you can't really see it. But overall, it's pretty nice. The weathering is a little over the top for me. Like, why is there so many scratches here when these lenses are in the way? So usually the damage would be on around the edges and on the edges of the lenses. But somebody went ham with the silver paintbrush there. That is a little too much for me. And this green is a little weird to me too. So like I did with my Proton Pack, I made it kind of my own kind of movie related. I'm going to do the same with these goggles. So remember this now. And I will do a follow-up video of my modifications. But this is pretty cool. Got this rubber face thing here. I'm just going to be wearing this on my head. I highly doubt, let's see. I'm going to wear this. Yeah, it gives you kind of like tunnel vision when you wear this. I think there's lights. It's actually pretty hard to turn. Oh, there we go. There's some lights there. Some dusty lenses. Pretty cool. It's kind of how you see it from the inside. You wear these on your head. It might be a little blinding when wearing this, but overall, this is pretty cool. These things turn. This one turns a lot more freely. Yeah. Might change this to an actual butt, like a immovable button there. Straps are fine. I'm okay with that. It's really just a prop hanging around my head. I might replace these with actual screws, but first and foremost, I need to repaint this because this is just kind of crazy. Other ones that I've seen online have very little, and people complain that it was too much weathering, but this is absolutely too much weathering. Yeah. Well, overall, it's pretty good. I believe that this is supposed to come with stickers. This one did not come with stickers. That's unfortunate. Because in this picture, it has some stickers on there. Either they forgot to apply it, or they forgot to give me the sticker sheet. Uses two AAA batteries. Yeah, it's supposed to include stickers. So I gotta call Spirit Halloween and find out what's going on with that. Because all the other props that you can buy, I guess from Halloween.com or other places, they have a different type of goggles. It's more shiny green plastic, and it definitely doesn't have the stickers. I purposely bought this one from Spirit Halloween from the US and paid the US shipping because it had those, kind of movie accurate licensed stickers. So that is unfortunate. And also, what I also noticed is these this tape has already been opened, so maybe this was like a return, or maybe it was like a store display. I know it's off season, so maybe this is just something they had lying around and they sent it to me. So that is something I gotta find out. I guess before I start this whole rethink thing. But yeah, that's my quick and dirty unboxing video for these Spirit Halloween Ghostbuster Ecto Goggles. It's gonna be pretty cool. And yeah, I'll keep you guys updated. Alright, please like and subscribe. Catch you guys on the next one. Peace. Okay, so this is 3 weeks later. Finally got in the set of stickers and I was able to paint and weather this all. Spirit of Halloween, or Spirit Halloween, they were a little tight. They didn't want to send me another set of stickers. I guess they probably thought that I maybe screwed up putting them on and I just wanted to cop another set. But I had sent them my video that I did prior to this one and they realized, okay, maybe there wasn't a set in it. Maybe it was the showroom display model. So they did send me another set of stickers, and it would have been nice if they sent me 2 sets, but they only sent me 1. It took a while, they just put it in the mail with a stamp, and I received them. So here they are, I've installed them. If you guys can't tell, I have already repainted this whole thing, and I kind of added my own touches to it, and I'm gonna go over it with you guys. So, I basically bought a satin or flat green paint that I thought looked nice, and I basically painted this whole thing with it. But first, what I did was, these were 2 shiny black plastic for me, kind of looked like this one here. So I masked this part off because I wanted this front part to be shiny, and I masked the silver off, and I masked these silver pins off. And I just gave it a quick spray of matte black paint, and I got this nice finish to it. And then I let that dry for an hour, and then I taped it all off, including the lenses. And then I sprayed this all green. Actually, I did tape off this, and I taped off this. If you can see here, there's some of that matte black that kind of got onto it, which was nice because I kind of like that weathering. So then I masked everything off. I even pulled the strap off. I'll get to that later, a little modification that I did. And I taped all of this off. I'll show you guys pictures, show it to you now. Of what I did. And then I basically put this, you know, on my little box thing that you saw there. I just basically cut the front of the box, folded it down, put that in so it helps protect it from overspraying anything around. And then I sprayed this whole thing green. Let that dry. I mean, I gave it light coats, let it dry 10 minutes per coat, and then did another spray, then another spray. And then once it was done, I brought this in and I just started to paint all of these rivets or these hex bolts black. Did some weathering here, put some weathering on the silver. And a nice little trick that I did was I put a lot of black inside these edges and then I would just wipe it with my fingers because it kind of looks like a lot of dirt and grit that's stuck inside there. I think it gives it a really cool effect. Right, and then I hit the tops of these with some silver and then weathered it with some black. You know, I just put a dab of black on it and just wipe it with my finger so it just gives it that darkened look. And then after that was all done, I took some silver and because I don't know if you saw the picture from before. I'll show you a picture of before now. And then, so you can see that there was all the silver in the front face, which was kind of stupid. Like, how would you get all that silver on the front face when these lenses are in the way? There's no way that that would happen. So I weathered it kind of like how I thought where the wear edges would be, which would be here, that edge, that corner, these corners here, and the top, like exposed edges, right? You know, maybe across here. And yeah, that's basically it. And then after I was done, I put the stickers on here. And I have a little tip for you guys for this sticker here. Before I put it on, I measured it that it was just maybe a hair thicker than this piece here. So I put it on a cutting board, and I just cut off some of the white at the bottom and at the top. And now it gives it a nice border on there that fit perfectly. And so that was nice. And I did that too with the battery on off. Like, it is just ever so slightly wider than this battery cover here. If you put it anywhere else, you wouldn't be able to open the battery cover. So I just shaved off some of the top, some of the bottom, and it fits perfectly onto there. And then with this one, they want it to be placed in here, but it actually overshoots it by about this much and about this much. So you get it all crinkled all along here, and especially in this corner, because I think they made this to an actual size of what the goggles are supposed to be. And in these ones, it's way smaller. So I found that it fit nicer this way, sideways. So at least you can read it this way, right? And then when it fit this way around this knob here, it overshot here by like 2-3 millimeters. So then I took my X-Acto and I cut it off, and I cut off basically rule number 7, which was don't cross the street, which is stupid, because that's not on usually any of the other stickers. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then 7 was don't cross the street. So that's kind of silly, and I didn't need it. So I was able to cut it directly on here with an X-Acto knife, and I got the perfect contour. And I think that looks really good there. Versus it not fitting in this area here. So once I did put all the stickers on, I weathered it with some black paint, and they were super glossy, so the paint didn't really stick on there. So you gotta go really light and let it dry, and then kind of smudge it, because doing acrylic paint on that was almost like dry erase. Like, you just wipe it completely off. And I did that for here too, and then for there. This one I kind of left alone. And then after all was said and done, I gave it a good few coats of matte clear, and it also seals in the sticker, so I don't have to worry about them like fraying off or, you know, picking up, because they are just paper stickers, paper pack stickers. And then it, yeah, just locked everything in, and I think it looks great. One thing I do have to note is after I did clear it, it kind of dulled out the silver, obviously, because it's matte paint, right? So I just went over again with some silver to give it more of a metal look. And I think it looks fantastic. Yeah. And then one really cool thing that I did was, I don't know if you guys noticed before, but I did this kind of strap on it with this button. The original was, it literally looked like this, and it had a rivet. I thought that just looked so unfinished, especially on the sides of these pieces here. More accurate was if I put a button there and then I just clip the button through there. But I mean, I'm just using this for Halloween, and I don't want to go too crazy on it. But because I had pulled the strap off of that rivet that was there, there was no way in hell that I would be able to get it back onto it. So I just bought these buttons from Amazon. And this screw is too small to go through there, so I put a drywall anchor in there, crazy glued it in, let it dry, put some baking soda on it, because then it reinforces the crazy glue. And then after I let it dry for about 20 minutes, I was able to screw this in, and it holds really well. And then easy, it comes with all the tools, you just drill a hole there, and then you tap it in, and then you hammer the rivet so it holds. This piece here, I just literally cut it out of a piece of leather that I had lying around. It was just like something like this, and I took this with a pen and got the shape, cut it out, and then made it a little longer because I wanted it to go over the goggle. And I hand sewed it. That's my first attempt ever at sewing. Did such a horrible job. It was horrible on this side because this is where I started, and then it got a lot better on this side. I didn't want to redo it, so it's good where it is, the way it is, and then just snap it on there. I think it gives it a really good look. Now I kind of want to put some... it's just a lot of work. I don't want to do it. So I'm just going to leave it. So, because like, if you wanted to do it, you'd have to screw in one of those screws there for the button. You have to cut off this whole ear on it, and then I have to repaint it. So I'm just going to leave it as is. I think it looks fine. But yeah, I think the overall look is really good. It looks so much better than before. Now it looks like a really good movie prop. What I did order from Ghostbusters fans is GBFans.com was the actual black knobs here. These are so thin, and my hands are so dry, I can never turn this well. Yeah, I can't even turn that off. So when I get those new, black knobs in, hopefully that I can either fit it over this or glue it, so then it's a lot higher and they have knurled edges. So it'll be easier to turn. This is just, I can't do it. I just can't do it. There, at least it's off. But I don't want to be doing that. I want to be able to just, when I wear it, just turn it, it's on, turn it, it's off. So I'm going to replace both sides with them. Hopefully they're the right size for this. This is a little scaled smaller, and the Ghostbusters fans one is scaled to the right size, so it might be a little big. Hopefully I can hollow the inside out and then just get it over this. Because I tried to pry this off before, and I'm not sure how it's attached on the inside. So. And to do that, you'd have to rip all this out, and I really did not want to do that. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I looked at some reference photos, and I noticed that they had these random screws on the top here, kind of one wider screw and one smaller screw, so I just added them on the top there, and I had this old gun sight part here, this metal part. This pretty much weighs, I don't know, it's the heaviest part on this whole goggle, but it gives it some weight. And I had like a aluminum washer that I put underneath there. So I glued the aluminum washer down, I drilled a hole, and then I tapped in the screw with this knob, and now I can actually turn it. And without scratching the base here. So you just tighten this just snug, and then it just gives you enough play to move it. And as you see, as I turn it, the screw doesn't move, so it's not unscrewing it. I am going to take this off and then put a dab of crazy glue on it and then screw it in where I need it so that I know that it's secure. But I think that's pretty cool. Gives it that really nice effect, and I put it for the on-off, so on-off. I wish that was actually over there. It would be so much easier to turn. But yeah, just little things that I added onto it. It's not the most accurate piece. The Hollywood collectibles one, but this is great just to have fun with, to play around. It's only $29 US, and then about 3-4 hours of your time to make it look the way that I did, and I think that it looks perfect, and I don't have to worry about this, maybe total $50 worth of mods including this onto it and my time just to wear for Halloween, and not have to worry about a $399 US toy that's gonna, or collectible that's going to fall off my head, or people are going to want to touch it and wear it. So I think this looks great. Thank you, Spirit of Halloween, for making something so fun and affordable and easily moddable. I think that it looks fantastic. So I'll give you guys a little slow turn of this. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Please like and subscribe. And happy modding, happy collecting, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Okay, I'm just gonna throw this part in here. After I just finished my video, like you just saw, I was packing everything up and I was throwing it into my camera drawer when I found these aluminum knurled edged knobs. And I was like, these look like the perfect size to go over those silver side pieces. And then I put them up against it and it worked. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna glue them. So I mixed up some epoxy because I want them to be very permanent, and I stuck them on, and it looks so good. The other side looks good. This side looks a little bit more messy. So what happened was it was clear epoxy, and I did this side first, and then after I was like, oh, it's clear, so I'm gonna have to paint it. So for this side, I mixed the epoxy, then I dropped in some black acrylic into the epoxy and mixed it up. And now I got this. So now it's black. And then so for this side, it was already half dried. So I picked it out with a screwdriver, and then I mixed some more clear epoxy and added black in it, and then dabbed it over top. So at least, because if I painted it afterwards, it's not gonna probably last very long, and this way at least it's the actual color all the way through, so it doesn't matter if it gets scratched or whatnot, it's still gonna be black. So after that dried, I put some clear gloss acrylic clear coat on top, and then once that dries, I'm just gonna weather it a little bit and just give it a couple of scratches, and I think it's gonna look good. So yeah, these were free, but I still paid for the Ghostbusters fans one, but I didn't know if those were gonna fit perfectly, but I know that these ones fit very, very well. And then what I did was I painted the silver knobs, plastic ones that are underneath it, black. So it gives it that matte black look on the bottom, and like the sooty look, and then the clear metal black knob there. I'm gonna show you how easy it is now to turn this. So that's a positive click on, and then positive click off. Like off. On, off, on, off, off. It is so good. I'm so happy with it. And now these goggles are done. So yeah, just wanted to update you instead of doing a whole other YouTube video. But yeah, like, subscribe, comment below, let me know what you think, and yeah, I will catch you guys on the next one. Peace.